I know you're wondering what coin flipping has to do with this k-mean clustering. I promise I will explain in this section. And in the previous section, we learned that if hidden vector is known, that we can derive parameters through dot product. But in reality, neither hidden vector nor parameters are known. And therefore, it is unclear how to derive the biases of the coin. Let's start from a simpler problem. Let's imagine for a second that parameters are actually known. Let's start from this example. The parameters are 0.35 for the blue coin, 0.80 for the green coin. Can we derive the hidden vector? Well, let's say, what is the most likely coin to generate the first sequence of flip where the fraction of heads is 0.4? Well, we can compute the probability that the first sequence was generated by the blue coin. And this probability turned out to be 0.00113. We can also compute the probability that it was generated by the green coin, and it turned out to be a much smaller number, 0.00003. Which coin is more likely? Of course, the blue coin is more likely to generate the first sequence. Which coin is more likely to generate the second sequence with these 9 heads? Well, we do the same calculation. It turned out that probability of the second series of flips to be generated by the blue coin is much smaller than the probability of it being generated by the green coin. And therefore, the most likely coin for the second series of flips is green. And by continuing this way, we can derive the hidden vector. And it brings us to the following idea. Yes, we do not know parameters or hidden vector when we start evaluating the biases of coin. But let's start from randomly chosen parameters. As soon as parameters are chosen, we can derive the hidden vector. As soon as the hidden vector is derived, we question our wisdom in selecting the initial parameters and estimate the parameters using data and hidden vector as I described before through the dot product. In this way, we will arrive to the new parameters. As soon as the new parameters are derived, we once again to evaluate the hidden vector and iterate. We came up with an approximation algorithm for evaluating parameters for the coin flipping. And let me show you how this algorithm works. We start from randomly selected parameters. As soon as parameters are selected, we form a hidden vector, so we assign each series of flips to either blue coin or red coin. As soon as a hidden vector is derived, we can use this hidden vector to derive new parameters. As soon as this new parameter is derived, we construct new hidden vector, and we iterate until convergence. Does this algorithm remind you something? Of course, it is the k-means algorithm, or something very similar to the Lloyd algorithm in disguise. Where are the data, hidden vector, and parameters in k-means clustering? Well, data are obviously the set of data points. What are the parameters? Parameters are, of course, the positions of the centers. And what is the hidden vector? Hidden vector is simply assignment of data points to k centers, which is an n-dimensional vector with its coordinates from 1 to k. This assignment hidden vector is shown below by green coordinates. So we figure out how to solve the coin flipping problem and what relationship it has to k-means clustering. And now we'll talk about a more general approach called expectation maximization.